Coming up on Mountain News this morning, we have the details about a deal that is being called one of the largest emergency aid packages in U.S. history. And we talked with a Kentucky native currently living in New York City, which is the current epicenter for the COVID-19 outbreak in the United States. And we take a look at exactly how health officials at UK are performing and testing samples of suspected COVID-19.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News This Morning.
Good morning. The time is now 5 o'clock, and thank you for joining us on Mountain News This Morning. I'm Lacey Roberts, and today is Friday, which means we have made it through this week. And yesterday, the weather was just gorgeous. Let's bring in Brandon Robinson. You were right. That sun was out. It was hot, and I actually went for a run, and it felt hotter than what it looked like outside.
It did, and I actually got a little bit of a sunburn on my left arm here just a little bit. It wasn't that bad. I was out for about an hour or so. But listen, when you're pale skin like I am, it doesn't take much. I had my hat on, though, so all good up here. Let's see what's going on this morning, and it's still quiet across the region. Some green off to our north, but a little bit of cloud cover starting to work its way back in, so not as much sunshine as yesterday. We'll still see some. It'll just be mixed in with some clouds. Very, very mild this morning. 68, Jackson, Hazard, Prestonsburg, Pikeville, Logan, 61 Somerset, 72 in Williamsburg, and 55 in Jonesville. The winds are cranking out of the southwest, and that's going to dry some much warmer air in here. Not a whole lot warmer than yesterday, but very similar to it. Iced coffee on the coffee meter this morning because everybody's above that threshold there. Out the door forecast again. Sunshine early mixed with more clouds later on today, and temperatures will climb close to 80 by this afternoon. Lacey.
Thank you, Brandon. The House is expected to follow the Senate in passing a $2 trillion stimulus package to address the coronavirus pandemic. The White House says President Trump is eager to sign the bill quickly. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell says the economy may well be in recession already. And in relation to that stimulus package, we have received dozens of calls and messages from seniors who worry that they won't get rescue checks. And we wanted to know as well. So we reached out and talked to Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell directly. His office told us that any U.S. resident with a Social Security number that is not claimed as a dependent is eligible. In a statement, they said this does apply to those who have no income, as well as those who receive income from non-taxable means-tested benefit programs, such as Social Security. Now, the question still remains, though, if they will receive the same amount as other U.S. citizens. Individuals who earn up to $75,000 will receive $1,200. Families will earn an additional $500 per child. And as the COVID-19 outbreak impacts many parts of the country, New York State and the greater New York City area remain one of the heavily impacted areas. Hospitals seeing extremely high numbers of cases with a decreasing amount of beds. Anniston Kane, a Kentucky native, works as a patient care assistant at a New York City hospital. She says she continues to try and stay healthy so she can serve those in need.
Making sure I'm wearing gloves, wearing the proper PPE, whatever that may be for that specific patient, for that specific room. And then as soon as I get out, making sure I'm practicing good hand hygiene and sanitizing everything that I can.
Kane says that her hospital is rationing medical supplies like masks. And for now, she recommends to continually use good hygiene, practice social distancing, and protect those most vulnerable to try and stop spreading COVID-19. And back here in Kentucky, Governor Beshear is urging everyone to stay healthy at home as we try to stop the spread of coronavirus. Now, there are now at least 248 cases of COVID-19 in Kentucky. The governor announced 50 new cases last night. It's the highest one-day total of new cases. The governor says Kentucky still has not seen the peak of the virus yet, and he says it's critical everyone do their part to social distance and protect Kentuckians. He also urged county judge executives and mayors to make sure large groups are not gathering at parks. The Lexington Herald Leader reports a McCreary County woman who tested positive for the virus had to be ordered by a judge to stay home. This after health officials said she refused to quarantine herself. Now, they received complaints to their hotline about the woman from people who saw her out in public. Violating the order could lead to criminal charges. And in last night's news conference, Governor Beshear said a 90-year-old man who was at a nursing home in Perry County had a confirmed case of COVID-19, But a short time later, it was announced the result was actually negative. Yesterday, we talked with Public Health Director Scott Lockard, who says typically, once a COVID-19 test is processed at the state lab, the local public health directors are notified before Governor Beshear gives his daily news conference. Lockard says while the state was processing more tests yesterday, a mistake was made.
What happened today in this process is we had not received any notification until the governor had already went on air, and then right as he was going on air, I received notification that this was pending, and so evidently the governor was provided some misinformation that this test was positive when in fact it was still pending.
Lockard says if there is a positive case in Perry County, he will be notified and will work with local officials to make sure everyone is informed. But again, as of this morning, there are still no confirmed cases in Perry County. And yesterday, doctors at UK gave us an inside look at how they administer and test samples for coronavirus. The test itself is uncomfortable. A long nasal swab collects the sample up the nose, and it's taken to the lab for testing. For almost 1 week, doctors at UK have been processing 94 tests at one time and have now processed nearly 1,000. Hazard Community and Technical College is also joining the efforts to help others during this outbreak. HCTC is donating what supplies they have from their allied healthcare programs and science labs to local clinics, hospitals, veteran centers, and nursing homes. President Dr. Jennifer Linden says they hope that they can get these items to those who need it most.
We're donating items like gloves, gowns, masks, anything that can be used for personal protective equipment.
Dr. Linden says the facilities have responded with excitement about receiving those supplies. Well, thank you for getting your day started with us here on Mountain News this morning. Coming up, we'll show you how Kentucky's Attorney General is cracking down on price gouging right here in the Commonwealth.
Well, we'll add in some more clouds and some stray rain chances today. Our temperatures will be just as warm or maybe a little bit warmer than yesterday. I'll have your weekend forecast in 3 minutes.